It's not your fault, but it is your responsibility. What am I on about? Stay tuned to find out.
You're listening to the Keith Blakemore-Noble radio show. Here's your host, Keith Blakemore-Noble.
Hey, hello, hello, welcome back, welcome to another episode. So today we're going to be taking a look at things like cause and effect, reasons, results, fault. Are we at fault for things that happen? Whose responsibility is it? We're going to take a look at all of that, and hopefully you'll find this empowering. So, when things happen, stuff happens, something causes it to happen. That's just the way things are. That's the fundamental way the universe works. Cause and effect. Something causes something else to happen. Something happens because something happened before it, which caused it. Cause and effect. Now, there are those who believe everything happens for a reason. Well, yes, technically everything does happen for a reason. Things happen because something else caused it to happen. That is very true. But there are many people who believe that the reason something happens is us. We're the reason. It's to teach us something. It's to help us grow, develop. There's something we have to learn. The universe is teaching us something. I'm going to disagree with that. Stuff happens. And sometimes it is just stuff happens. It's not necessarily for our benefit. It's not necessarily to teach us something. There's not necessarily something for us to learn. If somebody gets raped, they're not getting raped because there's a lesson for them to learn. Absolutely not. And anyone who does push that line is being incredibly disingenuous, then being incredibly hurtful to the victim of that crime. Sometimes things happen because nasty stuff happens. My point, however, is stuff will happen, and it's not our fault. We don't cause much of what happens to happen. Now, yes, sometimes you will be the cause of things that happen to you. No two ways about it. Many other times, though, it's not your fault. You didn't cause whatever disaster befell you. You didn't necessarily cause that. It's not your fault. It wasn't something you manifested. It wasn't because you believed the wrong thing. It's not because the universe is trying to teach you a lesson. Sometimes stuff happens because it happens. Excuse me. It's just the way it is. However, although whatever happened isn't our fault, it's not our fault, it is our responsibility. Now, what I mean by that is we have a responsibility for how we react, how we respond, our response. Our responsibility is us. We can always choose how we respond to something. You always have a choice. Whatever happens, you always have a choice in things. Sometimes the choice isn't a nice selection of choices, but you do always have a choice. I mean, for example, suppose you're in a bank. You're the manager of a bank. Armed robbers come in, point the gun at you, open the safe, or we'll shoot. You've got a choice. You could not open the safe and perhaps get shot, or you could open the safe, let the robbers get there, get the contents of the safe, and hopefully you and all of your staff survive. You do have that choice. Now, the banks will tell their staff, yep, if that happens, hand it over. We're insured. Your life is worth much more than the money. However, suppose that it wasn't a bank, but suppose you were in charge of a command centre, and in the safe were the codes to launch your country's nuclear weapons. Masked men break in, armed with guns, pointing the gun at you. Open that safe, give us the codes, or we'll shoot you. Now it's a different choice. Now it's the same choice. Do you open the safe and give them the contents, or do you get shot? none of us would know exactly how we're going to react in that situation, and unless we were actually in it, and hopefully nobody is ever in that situation. But we probably have an idea of how we at least might like to think we would react. If we hand over the codes, the entire world could be wiped out, for example. Neither's a good choice. Do we condemn the whole world, or do we die and potentially protect the whole world? Well, you always have a choice. It's not always nice. And now, usually the choices aren't that severe, thankfully. However, you always have a choice. And that includes in how you react to something. Ever found yourself saying, "Oh, so-and-so makes me so angry"? Think about it. They don't make you angry. You, at an unconscious level, quite possibly, but you choose to be angry in response to whatever it is they're thinking, saying, or doing. Usually saying or doing, because you can't really respond to what people are thinking. We're not really telepathic. But they'll say or do something, and your response is to become angry. They haven't made you become angry. They haven't made you become angry. You have, at some level, chosen to become angry. And we can choose different ways to behave. Now, depends on our psychological makeup, depends on how we've been conditioned and brought up and all of this sort of thing. Sometimes it might be easier, sometimes it might be harder, but fundamentally we always have that choice of how to react. Same when things go wrong. If something goes wrong, we could throw a strop and get angry about it, or something goes wrong, we could get really upset about it and bemoan how unfair it is that it's gone wrong yet again. Oh, these things always go wrong. Or we could go, right, this has gone wrong. This very unpleasant thing has happened. What can I do to make things better? What positive things can I do off the back of this? We always have the ability to respond and choose the way in which we respond. So when something happens to us, we have no control over what happened, but we do have control over how we react to it. And that can be a very empowering thought. The fact that we are in control of ourselves, we have the ability to choose how we react. It can also be rather an unpleasant thought for many of us, as we realise, ooh, when I exploded because that happened and I flew off the handle, that was my fault. It wasn't my fault that the thing happened, but it was my fault that I reacted that way. Ooh, yeah, that sometimes can be a bit unpleasant, can't it? But remembering that it's how we choose to respond that's important. There's a tale of there's a story of two people who unfortunately found themselves in a concentration camp. One of them decided, this is it. This is horrible. Life is over. There's no point in living. And sure enough, they passed away through the horrific environment there. The other person decided, this is horrible, this is horrific. I have to do whatever it takes to survive so that I can tell others about this so that it doesn't happen again. They then survived and they went on to tell their story and share it with the world. Two people, the same thing happened to them, they were in the same environment. Neither of them, in neither case was it their fault. Absolutely not their fault. But they were responsible for how they reacted to it, how they responded to it. One of them gave up. One of them, it gave them the drive and determination to do whatever it took to survive. When things happen to us in life, and they do happen to us, they happen to us, we can choose how to respond. Now, when we do this, basically ask yourself, am I at cause or am I at effect? Am I at the effect of everything that's happening to me? Is my life the result of all the things that happened to me? Or am I going to place myself at cause? Things will happen, and I will cause my own response and reaction to that, and cause new things to happen as a result, cause my life to go in particular ways as a result of what has happened, because I choose how to react. If something goes wrong and you find yourself in a situation, pause and ask yourself, the way I'm responding here, my response, my reactions, am I at cause or am I at effect? Am I passively allowing this to happen to me? Or am I taking charge of the aftermath and creating something from it? Another way you might look at it is the difference between reasons and results. When something happens, do you immediately look for reasons? Or do you go for results? I could have been running that company, but I didn't get the chance. I could have done this, but dot, dot, dot. I could have, but dot, dot, dot. I could have been a contender. Are you blaming your situation on other factors, external factors, things that happened? Are you talking about the reasons why you are where you are? Or, what if you focused on results? You went, okay, that happened. We're in this situation. Let's look at the result we want to get. How do we get there? So instead of always looking to apportion blame and looking for reasons why it didn't work out and reasons why things had gone wrong, reasons why it will never work and reasons why you could never succeed, instead of looking at those, the reasons, what if you look at the results that you want to? What if your focus is on the results of what you want to get? How can I take what's happened, turn that around, grow from where we are, and get what I want? It can take a strong mindset to do that. But that's the only mindset that's going to get you results. You see, whatever we focus on is what we're going to tend to get. What you focus on is what you tend to get. It's like a search engine. If you've got your search engine on your computer or your tablet, your phone, whatever, and you search in disaster, you type in disaster, you will get thousands, hundreds of thousands, millions of results. If you scroll long enough, you get millions of results all about disasters. And you might look at that and think, yeah, see, everything is disaster. The whole world is a disaster. Tell you what, let's look for famine. Let's do a search on poverty. Let's do a search on things going wrong. You will find millions of those. And that's all you will see. However, if instead you search for success, positive stories, riches, wealth, happiness, good health, search for any of those, again, you will find millions of results, all of which are positive, showing you success, happiness, good health, wealth, positive results, good fortune. Whatever it is that you search for, you'll find. And that's the same with our life. We are bombarded, constantly bombarded by, it's said, 2 million bits of information every second coming in through our eyes, our ears, our sense of touch, taste, smell, all of our senses, our hearing. 2 million bits of information coming in every second. That's a lot. We can't really focus on all of that. Our minds have never evolved to focus on all of that. We need to filter things down. Filter things down, we filter it using our own internal search engines. What your search engine is programmed to find, it will find. It's like that thing with a car. You know, that whole thing about you go out and buy, a blue Ford Mondeo. Do they even make Mondeos anymore? I don't know. But you buy that particular make, model and colour of car. All of a sudden, the next day, when you're looking out, you're driving along the motorway, the expressway, the roads, or whatever, or you're looking out at the roads, loads of blue Ford Mondeos around. What's going on? Has everybody suddenly gone out and bought the same car as you? Well, obviously, no, they haven't. Those cars are always there. But it's just that particular make, model and colour of car was of no real relevance to you before. Now it is relevant to you because you own one. It becomes an important piece of information. So when our sensors detect one, kind of flags up, we go, oh, look! And we then just decide, well, is that our car? Do we need to do something about it? Or is it not? That's why we suddenly become aware of them all. And it's the same as we go through life. Whatever we focus on is what we're going to see. I think it was Wayne Dyer says that where attention goes, energy flows and results show. It's the same thing. Whatever you're focusing your attention on, you will see more and more and more of that because that's what you're sorting for. That's what you're searching for. That's what you're looking for. So when things go wrong, if you're always looking for the reasons and you're always looking to dwell in the reasons and have a pity party and, oh, this has gone wrong and, oh, I haven't lost the weight I wanted to lose because this happened and da, 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 da. If you're always looking for the reasons, that's all you're ever going to see is reasons why it's not going to work. If you're always looking for failure, that's what you're going to see. If you're always looking for reasons why it won't happen, that's what you'll see. If you're always looking to see how you are at the effect of everything that's happening, my life is where it is because of all these things that happened to me. That's why my life is like it is. And you're always looking for these. That is what you will find. That is what you will see. And that will simply reinforce in your own mind that that's the way life is. And that's the way life will stay. On the other hand, if you kind of focus on and look, search for results, if you're always looking at results, if you're looking at where you want to go, if you're always looking to see how you can place yourself at cause, how you can create from whatever situation you're in, how you can use that to generate the results that you're looking for, how you can find the drive to continue through even the most appalling of situations. If you're always looking for how you can move it forward, how you can put yourself at cause in your life, looking for how you can best respond to create the results you want, then you'll start to create more of the results that you want. Now, I'm not saying that just by suddenly thinking this way, life's going to flip and suddenly everything's going to be roses. I wish it would. It would make my life much easier. It would make everybody's life so much happier. It's not how life works. However, that is how you will start to place yourself on the track to creating the kind of life that you want and getting the kind of results that you want because you are causing those results to happen rather than you are looking for the reasons for the effect that you're in, that you're experiencing. Which is why I say, we said when we came into this, it's when stuff happens, it's not your fault. So don't go blaming yourself, unless you actually made the thing happen. If you drove your car off the road, quite possibly it was your fault. But I'm talking about generally in life, when things happen, it's not your fault. I didn't get the promotion. That's not necessarily your fault. It's just there was somebody better suited to it applied at that time. That's not your fault. However, it is your responsibility. How you respond to that is absolutely within your control. You could mope about how unfair it was that you didn't get the promotion, or you could actively consider, okay, what was it that held me back from this promotion? What do I need to do to make sure next time I'm in with a much better chance of getting that promotion? Do I need to change the way I work? Do I need to work harder, better? Do I need to focus on different things? Do I need to consider whether this is the right environment or the right company for me? Perhaps I would be better off taking my skills to somewhere where they're better suited. Now, this spot could be featuring you. There are three different levels at which you can sponsor. We've got a bronze level, where you get to sponsor 1 month's worth of episodes of the Keith Blakemore-Noble Radio Show. You get your advert played in this part of the show. You get mentioned in the show notes. And you also get mentioned in most of the social media promo for those episodes. Or we've got the silver level, where you get all of that, plus You get sponsorship of the 5-Minute Meditation podcast as well. So you get promoted in 8 lots of show notes, 8 lots of promos, and you get mentioned with a link on the sponsorship page on the website. Or there's the top one, the gold level, where you get all of that. Plus, you get a guest blog on the KeithBlakemoreNoble.com website. Plus, we'll record a special bonus episode of the Keith Blakemore-Noble Radio Show featuring you. 3 different levels, whichever one you want, it's up to you. Just go to KeithBlakemoreNoble.com/show/support to find out more. And you could be our next sponsor in this spot. Now, where were we? It's not your fault, but it is your responsibility. Place yourself at cause. Cause things to happen in your life. Don't just wallow in the effects of it and look for the reasons why things happen. Place yourself at cause. Look at the results. Start building to create the results you want based on where you are, what you've got. And remember, you always have the control over how you respond. It's always in your power. Sometimes you can do it easily. Sometimes you might need to work with a coach to help flip that mindset around so that you don't always react. You don't always flip out when stuff happens. But it is possible to make that change. Absolutely possible to make that change. And when you do make that change, that's when life starts to turn around, because you're no longer focused on the reasons. You're no longer placing yourself at effect. You are taking responsibility. You are responding in a more positive way. You're looking for the results that you want. You're causing new outcomes in your life because you're taking action. You're acting positively. You are realizing that ultimately it's not my fault. What happened isn't my fault. But what happens next, that's my responsibility. And so it is for you. What's happened to you up to now, it's not your fault. What you do next, that's absolutely your responsibility. And if you don't take responsibility for it, if you just place yourself at effect, you'll just get buffeted around and bounced, and things are never going to get better until you take responsibility. Stand up, place yourself at cause, look for the results, look at the results you want, and realize it's not your fault. But what happens next, that is your responsibility. What do you think? Let me know. Hopefully you enjoyed that. Hopefully you found that useful. Give us a like, a comment, a share, a subscribe, a review. Let me know what you're going to do differently as a result. I look forward to hearing how you are going to start taking responsibility for the next steps in your life. And I look forward to catching you in another episode very soon. Bye for now.
You've been listening to the Keith Blakemore-Noble Radio Show. To find out more, please visit KeithBlakemoreNoble.com.